This is what my finished heart looks like, and as you can see, it's still on the same size piece of backing fabric. I've not cut that out, and the reason why I haven't cut it out is because I've been playing with a few bits of lace. I am regretting now that I just embroidered the heart onto the backing fabric and didn't do what I thought I might play with, which was to actually embroider the heart on top of some pieces of broderie anglais. And another thing that came to mind was that it would have been nice to have embroidered it over the top of a piece of netting or voile like this, with the lace at the bottom, and so that my heart was actually on top of this. And I know that what I could do is actually I could cut away the voile to show the embroidery through it, but it's not really the look that I want, and I am so regretting that I didn't stitch it over the top of this lovely piece of lace. It would have looked so lovely just having that at the bottom, and just keeping it really, really simple, and that would have tied in with the other pages that I've got happening for this little journal. But I didn't do that, so I have to walk away. Another idea I had was, rather than use this edging here on this hanky, I could actually edge my page with that, which is some contemporary lace on, as you can see, on some voile or netting again. But I'm still going to stick with my original idea and use this lace here. Now, it's very, very fine, and there are places, if I can find them, as you can see here, where the actual handkerchief is coming away from the edge of the lace. So I will need to be very careful how I snip that all away so that I get an edge here that I can actually stitch down onto my background fabric here. I'm going to have to piece at some point my lace, but I think I'm going to be able to do that. So that's my next job. So I'm going to get on and do that now, and I will be back when that is done. So I finally managed to cut away my piece of lace from the handkerchief, and oh my goodness, what a job. I really had to be very, very ginger how I did that, because it's so fine. So I've got it out in one piece. There are one or two places, as you can see here, where the lace is coming apart. Now, I could mend that quite easily with doing a little bit of needle lace to secure that in place, but I'm going to try to avoid using that piece, because I have, oh, that one's gone as well. So one of these two at opposite edges, I'm going to have to do that little bit of repair work. So that's roughly what it's going to look like, but obviously, as I mentioned before, I'm going to have to snip my lace and then do a little bit of piecing, because I want these lovely corner edges. I want a piece going across the top, down the side, and obviously along the bottom, and this is much too big, so I'm going to have to do a little bit of creative snipping and reconnecting so that I can get my piece. So the next job that I've got to do, obviously, is to repair one of these corners. I might as well repair both of the corners that are slightly damaged, and then I need to cut my backing fabric to the size of my journal pages so that I know where to adhere my lace to. Now, originally, I think I had the idea of connecting my lace to the edge of the page. Let me pull that down a little bit. Sorry, I've got a very sleepy cat off to one side here, so I'm kind of having to work around him at the moment. He's fast asleep, so if you hear any snoring, it's not me, it's him. That makes a change, I have to say. But anyway, I'm off at a tangent as always. So as I was saying, originally I thought, I thought I was going to connect my lace along the edge of this portion here to the edge of my fabric. Well, I don't think I'm going to do that now because this is so delicate. What I think I'm going to do is maybe cut my page so that my fabric is going behind the centre of the lace, because I think that will give it a bit more support. And also I think it's quite pretty, as you can see here, with the blue coming through the white, which I've tried to do throughout this blue journal. So I'm going to get on and get those little bits of repairs done and the page cut, and I will be back shortly. So this is how my finished page is looking, and I have to say I'm really pleased with it. I wasn't sure about using this lace at all, as you could probably gather from the little bit of auditioning I did earlier on with other laces. But actually, I'm really happy now that I've gone to the edge of my page with the lace. This is what it looks like on the reverse, and of course none of that will show. I've used this Invisifil applique thread. If you watch my channel, you know I use this all the time. It's brilliant for doing concealed stitches, which is what I wanted on here for attaching my lace. And there we go, something was bugging me there. So I'm really happy, as I say, with this. I haven't quite got the join as well as I would have liked. I think if I hold that up to the camera, I'll do some photos at the end. So you know where that join is, but I think if you look closely, you'll spot it. But otherwise, you might not. So okay, so there's nothing left for me to do to this page other than pop it in a little cellophane bag like I put all my others in. And the reason I'm mentioning these is because one or two of you have emailed me to ask what they are. They're just normal cellophane bags that you would get greeting cards in or something like that. And I just pop my finished pieces in a bag like this and seal it up just to keep it clean until I am ready to use it. And I get these on Amazon. They're not particularly expensive at all. If I can remember, I'll put the link in the description box down below. You get probably about 50 or 100 for £3-4 or so. But I use these for all sorts of things. I use them in my journals, and they are particularly useful for keeping my pages clean and neat until I'm ready to put them in my fabric Journal of Stitchery journal. So that's this piece done. I've got another page that I'm doing for the second prompt that Rachel gave, which was painting. I thought I would carry on and just very quickly show you what I've done on that. I managed to find just one small piece of this scalloped edged fabric, and true to form, I made a bit of a boo-boo when I was creating my background. Normally I have the join along the bottom, and on this one I've put the join along the top. And the reason I like the join along the bottom is because when I attach my pages into my journal, I'm going to be putting a little bit of lace over that to hide it. As you can see, I also haven't cut it straight, so I'm going to be doing that in a moment. You will have seen in a previous video that I was going to have a go at replicating part of this image on the front of Lorna Bateman's book. So I did a photocopy of the pattern, which is inside the book for tracing. So that's the pattern. And as you can imagine, not much of that, this pattern is going to fit on there. So what I did was I reduced the pattern down on my printer, and I'm probably going to get about that much of the pattern on my page. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take my piece of fabric and this image, using my light box, I'm going to trace the pattern onto my fabric so that I've got my image there ready for stitching. But before I actually start stitching, I've got a little bit of painting to do, because the prompt for this page was paint or hand-dyed fabric or painting, so I thought I'd have a go at doing a little bit more of my previous attempt at painting. All right, everybody, so I'm going to get on with that. When I've got some pictures to show you, I'll come back with a part three video and we'll talk through what progress I've made. All right, until the next video, everybody, take care, and as always, thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate your company. Take care. Bye-bye now.